Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go over how to record your voice or audio over a microphone into FL Studio. The first step is to go to your options. We're going to go down to audio settings. Then we're going to select a device. It's important to select the Osseo devices so that when we get into what's called the mixer, we then have microphone inputs to work with. So select an Osseo device from your list. Just click here to see your whole list. And you can see Osseo devices. Select any of the following. Your interface may come with its own Osseo device, so choose whatever one you like. Now we're gonna X out. And the next step is to go to the mixer. Now the point of the mixer is to route things. So like your microphone, external quarter inch inputs for recording stereo or recording synthesizers. So it's the same process even for synthesizers. The next step here is to click on a track where you want to record. So make sure, really make sure that you're on a blank mixer insert. I can't tell you how many times I've accidentally selected a track that had a hi-hat in it. And when I went to record, you heard a hi-hat behind my vocal. So really be sure that it's a blank track. Nothing is routed to this track. So right now I'm just using a blank project. So track one or insert one is where we're going to start. Now, since you've enabled Osseo, you can now select from your mic sources under input. So here you're going to see input. You're going to click here. You're going to see a big list of numbers. Your microphone, depending on your interface, it should tell you which inputs you're using. So usually you're going to be using inputs one and two. Okay. So by default, if you're ever confused, select one and two. Now, if you're recording mono, meaning one mic at a time, you don't select mic one and two. That's stereo. That means when you record over your mono microphone, your voice is going to sound like it's on the left side, okay, because it only picked up one signal and nothing was routed to mic two. So unless you're recording with two mics, I wouldn't select the stereo recording. Let's go to mono recordings. Okay, so I'm going to select mic one, which is my input on my interface, insert one or microphone one on the interface. So that's probably what it is for you. Select mic one. If not, it's probably mic two. If you have a bigger interface, just reroute. I'm sure you know what the numbers mean by that point. Use mic input one or two. You don't have to use the other numbers, but you can. As far as your audio interface. So now that you have input, what you need to do is arm the track for recording. I can't tell you how many times I hit record and it didn't record anything because this wasn't triggered. So if you want to record into the playlist, make sure you activate the arm disc to record. Now what we're going to do is select the type of recording we want to do. I found that the easiest way to kind of manage a project is to hit record and audio into playlist as an audio clip. Some like to record into Edison, but at the end of the day, you're going to be dragging the audio out of Edison anyway. So you might as well just record it as an audio clip. FL Studio, there are a lot of ways to do the same thing. So if you choose the way you like. I'm going to record audio into playlist as an audio clip, and that's going to automatically set FL Studio to do its countdown into recording. So only do the record when you're ready to record. And a quick tip is to leave a bar or two before the actual song, so it gets you ready. So even if you're counting down to zero, you can get ready for the actual song and recording. That's a quick tip, especially if you're recording live instruments. Okay. So this is how you record. So once I hit record, it stops. And now you can hear my voice.
Set FL Studio to do its countdown.
Let me turn up my
into recording.
So only do the record when you're ready to record. I'm going to do this one more time. Let me turn down my headphones so I don't hear myself in the mic. And I'm going to go to the mixer now. And you can see that the arm disc to record button is off. So if I go to record again, audio into playlist, okay, so it automatically armed this track, but sometimes it doesn't
do
that.
Its countdown.
Okay, so I don't know when, but it occurs sometimes. You're going to be, giving a lot of effort into your take, but you didn't arm it to record, and it's not going to show anything. So sometimes what happens is if you hit record, then you X out, you can see the record button still highlighted. So you may think that you're recording audio, but if you go back to your mixer, you notice the arm disc button is off. So that's what may happen to you. And then you might hit play and you want to record, but there's nothing happening. Again, always check to make sure your arm disc recording is on. So now when I hit play,
automatically
now when I hit play, I can record
it.
Okay. So always make sure that arm to disc recording. I can't tell you how many times I've spent, you know, making a good guitar riff and it just didn't record. Okay, so that is how you record into audio, I mean, record into audio form in FL Studio. The benefits of recording into audio are that you have more manipulation over the sample. You could chop it, flip it. You can do a lot of cool things with audio. Make it, give it that stop and go effect, like sample records. So I'd really encourage you record your MIDI into audio, especially for your instruments, your vocals, and anything else. And this adds a different dimension onto your tracks. So thanks for watching today. That is how you record into audio form in FL Studio. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. And if you want to learn more about the music production as a whole, go to BusyWorksBeats.com/beginners. There we build out a course going over all the phases of music production, and I made it really easy for you so that you can get into it right away. Thanks for watching. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.